can go ahead with his topic, Dr. Arvind J. Over to you, Dr. Arvind J.
Thanks, Dr. Chintan, for the nice words. Thanks, Dr. Banshee and his team for making me a part of this event. Give me 1 minute's time so that I'll share my slides. Are you able to see my slides?
No, no, Dr. Arvind. So this like a Formula One race. All of us, we know that the nutrition plays an important role, and lots of us are having a very hectic lifestyle. Many of our patients, they do not have time to prepare their meals. And therefore, there is an evidence that obesity and overweight has increased in prevalence across the country. The number of ways we are targeting to reduce the obesity and the overweight, and one of them is in form of using the disease-specific formula. And all of you know that these disease-specific formulas, which come with special nutrients, which are apart from nutritional benefits, they have lots of other functional benefits. And I think, Dr. Arvind, we can see your screen.
Yeah. I'll put into PowerPoint mode.
Correct. Thank you.
I hope my PowerPoint, are you able to see my slides now?
Yeah, yeah. Please go ahead.
So good afternoon, everybody. My today's talk is on diabetes and specific nutritional formula, when and how much. It's very difficult topic because to finish in 15 minutes is a tough job, but I'm trying to make it justifiable. So first of all, greetings from Bangalore. I hope all of you are doing well in this tough corona times. Kindly take care of yourself, your family, as well as your patient accordingly. So if you see diabetes and obesity, obesity is known to be directly linked to type 2 diabetes, and not surprisingly, the growing prevalence of diabetes parallels the increased prevalence of obesity. Obesity and insulin sensitivity, the modest weight reduction of about 7% over a 6 month period through calorie reduction and increased physical activity improves the insulin sensitivity. On the right-hand side of the chart, you can see that the relationship between the body mass index and the risk of type 2 diabetes. So as the body mass index increases, the risk for type 2 diabetes also increases. You can see it's more so in women as well as in men. So factors associated with poor glucose control in hospitalized patients. You can see one of the reasons is uncontrolled or undiagnosed diabetes, medications that alter glucose level, critical illness, nutrition support, surgery or traumatic injury. 69% of the Indian diabetes have uncontrolled diabetes in spite of medication. The challenge is hidden in our plates. That is the most important thing for every diabetes. There is nothing like diabetes diet. It is always an individualized diet, because in Bangalore, for example, I'm telling, we come across so many different population where we have to advise the diet according to the patient needs. We can't just take say that you don't eat this, don't eat that. It has to be an individualized diet. So high refined carbohydrate intake is the universal common problem irrespective of the states, like whether it may be north, east, or south and west. So low fiber diet, low protein diet. So Indian diet scenario, if you take several studies, show that Indian diet mostly comprise of high carbohydrate, low protein, and low fat diet. Studies shows a comparison of macronutrients by region in India reveal similar patterns of dietary consumption that is relatively high carbohydrate and low fat and protein. Another study done on an Asian Indian and Chinese showed that as proportion of total energy intake, Asian Indians consumed less protein and more saturated fat than Chinese. So coming to the topic proper today, that is DSNF, that is diabetic specific nutritional formula. The nutrition therapy and physical activity are first line therapies for patients with diabetes. DSNF may be used as a component of MNT, that is medical nutrition therapy, to improve glycemic control, reduce body weight. The DSNFs are included in the ADA guidelines for diabetes management. That is very important. ADA as well as included in his the criteria in the management of diabetes. So what is DSNF? It's a diabetic specific high protein formula containing MUFA, that is slowly absorbed carbohydrates, and omega-3 HUFA enriched with EPA, DHA, and fiber gives rise to better glycemic homeostasis than a standard high protein formula and may also reduce the risk of acquired infection in ICU patients. So managing glycemic response. In Elia et al. Study, they conducted a systemic review and meta-analysis on the impact of using DSF for nutrition as oral nutritional supplements or as an enteral tubic feedings for inpatients or outpatients with diabetes. Compared with standard formulas, DSF significantly reduced the post-meal rise in the blood glucose, including lower peak glucose concentration and lower glucose area under the curve. The studies within the analysis found reduced requirements for insulin and fewer complications with DSF compared with the standard nutritional formula. Elia et al. Concluded that short and long-term use of DSF as oral supplements and tube feeds are associated with improved glycemic control compared with standard formulas. So managing glycemic response. In another study, a systemic review by Ojo and Broke provided further evidence that DSF are effective for managing glycemic status of hospitalized patients with diabetes on enteral nutritional tube feeding by improving postprandial glucose levels, HbA1c levels, and insulin responses. In outpatients with type 2 diabetes, Human et al. Showed that DSF improved glucose stabilization and management compared with a standard formula. D. Lewis et al. Showed reduced glycemic and insulinemic responses after administering DSF when compared to a standard formula. In these studies, DSF were found to safely and effectively lower high blood glucose level without increasing risk of hypoglycemia. So clinical evidence supports the use of DSF to help improve glucose level, reduce hypoglycemia.
Dr. Arvind, there is some audio problem.
Reduce insulin requirements.
Dr. Arvind, can you solve the audio?
So ADA recommends MRT, that is medical replacement Dr. therapy. Yeah? Okay, now it is okay?
Yeah, now it's okay. Go ahead.
ADA recommends MRT. So to
I think there is some internal glitch with you, doctor. Can you share the screen
now
again,
okay?
Doctor? We just share the screen, sir.
Now are you able to see?
No, not yet.
Okay, one second. Sorry.
Not an issue. Or else you go ahead perfect.
Sir, you can switch off your video, sir. You can switch off your video so that the internet connectivity issue will be less problem. You can switch off your video.
Okay, yeah.
consumer in video.
You can just expand the screen and
yeah
you have doctor now 4 minutes to complete the presentation.
Yeah, I'm almost done. So are you able to see my screen?
Yeah.
So ADA recommends MRT. So type of replacement in dietary content, that is liquid meal, solid meal, and breakfast replacement. As a partial meal replacement is there, that is the plan where one or more meals are replaced by commercially available vitamins and mineral fortified calorie reduced products, and at least one daily meal consisting of regular food, a meal that can be taken along with breakfast, lunch, and or dinner depending on the individual calorie intake. Recommendation as per various organization, you can see these. The commonest thing is carbohydrate is around 50 to 60%, fiber is 40 grams per day, protein is 12 to 20%, and fat is less than 21%. The goals of MRT is normal or near for normal as possible glucose, lipid, and blood pressure, prevent or slow down the rate of development of chronic complication, address individual nutrition needs, maintain pleasure of eating by only limited food choice when indicated by scientific evidence. So MRT decreases A1C by 1 to 2% and reduces LDL by 15 to 25%.
Again, Dr. Arvind, there are lots of audio problems. So you
dietary plan is carbohydrate 40%, fats. So meal high in fiber content, example vegetables and fruits. So structured dietary plan for weight reduction. So 40% of intake with a total daily intake of no less than 139 grams per deciliter. Compromise up to 20 to 30% of daily calorie intake. Remaining 30% should come from fat. Trans fat should be eliminated. Saturated fat should be reduced to 10% or even 7%. Meal plan should also focus on increased fresh fruits and vegetables and healthy carbohydrate consumption, especially foods high in fiber and with low glycemic index. So high protein and high dietary fiber helps in managing diabetes. So protein shakes and diabetes, everyone needs proteins which enables every cell to function. They help to maintain, rebuild, and repair muscles. So protein is a building block for the skin, nails, bones, and blades, and it makes up the hormones, enzymes, and antibodies. So our bodies create some proteins, but others must come from the diet. Protein food, such as the whey, meat, and tofu, enable the body to create the protein it needs. Apart from playing a key role in bodily process, protein may also have the other benefits for people with diabetes. Protein plays an important role in the management of diabetes. If you see this, high protein intake does not necessarily lead to weight loss. In some cases, higher protein intake may influence diabetes risk through weight loss. For individuals with type 2 diabetes, studies have demonstrated that moderate weight loss is associated with decreased insulin resistance, improved measures of glycemia and lipemia, and reduced blood pressure. So if you see the protein supplement in CKD, you can see around 0.8 to 8 grams per kg is recommended for stage 1 and stage 2. Stage 3 and stage 4, it is 0.6 to 0.8 grams per kg. In one of the clinical trials, this shows partial use of formula diet was much more effective in reducing body weight and also in improving coronary risk factors than conventional diet, in part due to reduced body weight through decreased energy diet intake and due to dietary composition of the formula diet. So greater weight reduction, reduction in the HbA1c, reduction in the systolic blood pressure, and increase in the HDL, reduction in the dose of medicine. So it really works. So liquid replacement and glycemic control in obese type 2 diabetes, they have looked into three aspects. Three types of food were given to the patient. What it says is liquid medical replacements are a safe and effective weight loss tool for obese patients in body weight, glucose, insulin, HbA1c and lipid levels. So in another study, it's a randomized control study where it says a significantly greater weight loss in subjects receiving the meal replacement plan compared to the regular diet, depending on the analysis and follow-up duration, the meal replacement group lost 7 to 8% body weight and the regular group lost 3 to 7% body weight. So in another one of the studies, Cochrane Library, taken from the Cochrane Library, the low can improve, clinically suggested that managed with improved level of glucose. So benefits of MRT, effective structured plan, behavior compliance improved, increases the nutritional knowledge, more regular meals, less snacks, a well-defined alternative to calorie-dense foods, portion control choice. So ladies and gentlemen, to conclude my talk, higher protein intake may reduce the risk of developing diabetes and improve metabolic control only when weight loss is achieved. 2020 ADA standards of care recommend diabetes medical nutrition therapy with regards to protein intake and dietary maximal function. The ADA recommends 0.8 to 1 gram per kg of proteins per day in earlier stages of CKD and 0.8 grams per kg per day in the later stages of CKD. These recommendations for protein intake are like those of the National Kidney Foundation. So medical nutritional therapy, diabetes nutritional supplements is a big topic, and it has to be stated conditions like hypertension, IHD, or any other medical problems the patient has got. You have to individually titrate and educate.